Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. The holidays should be a time of celebration and enjoying family, friends, and delicious food. But for some people, the holidays can bring feelings of loneliness, anxiety, and stress. But never fear, our sister Spirit is here. She's going to tell us how to beat the holiday blues. Spirit, welcome back to the show. Well, before we delve into everything, congrats on your new show.
Listen, I am so excited about this show. So it is five celebrities who have different, celebrity couples, who have different love goals, different issues that are playing in their relationships. They come into a house together and I get to work with them to help them heal their relationships.
And
show them how to connect those dots.
Very different from marriage boot camp.
Oh, no, 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 we don't do that. No, we give them a different experience, though. It's about showing them how to heal, right? As opposed to giving them situations to create. It's going to be something that you haven't seen
I'm
before.
Excited about it.
Y'all know how I do. This gives a chance.
Problems through love.
That's right.
I love that.
Love it, love it. So let's jump right into it. It's all about the holidays right now. We just celebrated Thanksgiving. But a lot of people are struggling, and things are, you know, not so great, and they fear this time of year, having lost loved ones, they might not be financially where they need to be. Mm-hmm. Talk to us a little bit about why that happens during the holidays.
Yeah, well, you know, first and foremost, we got to talk about mental health and wellness, right? Mm-hmm. This is a change of season, so some folks are dealing with seasonal affective disorder that we call SAD. We have anxiety, we have depression. We're having to interface with family members where we may not necessarily want to. Mm-hmm. You know, going back to places where we've experienced trauma, where we've experienced wounds, where we're not all happy-go-lucky. Mm-hmm. This is a hard time of year for a lot of people.
Absolutely.
Well, tell us a little bit about the behaviors that we should look out for with our friends, family, and even ourselves.
Mm-hmm. So what you're talking about here is you're talking about things like anxiety, you're talking about irritability, you're talking about withdrawing from folks. Mm-hmm. And I don't want us to just talk about the adults. We have to talk about the children, too.
Yes.
Because when you are dealing with your family separated, you know, you have folks, this is their first year with their parents not being together, first year for people going through divorce. Mm-hmm. You know, if you're not with your children during this time period, or your children aren't with you, if you've broken up with a mate, whether it's a husband or a boyfriend or a girlfriend, your children experience those losses too. Mm-hmm. If you've lost a loved one, they've lost their grandparents. So we have to remember that everybody may be suffering during this time of year, not just the grown-ups.
Yeah. That's true. Yeah. You know what I find that is prominent in all families is finances.
Oh, yes.
Because, you know, we're coming upon that, oh my God, I gotta get my kids all the Christmas gifts in the United States of America, or, you know, what am I gonna get my husband, my friend, or what am I gonna do this year, you know? So how do we get past financial anxiety? Do we just kinda say, I know I'm gonna spend all my money, or do we not spend all, like, what do we do?
We say, do not spend all of your money.
Yes.
Remember that the holidays are just one day, whether it's Kwanzaa or Christmas or whatever it is that you choose to celebrate. And remember, self-care is most important. Mm-hmm. This should be about love. This should be about meaning and connection. Don't spend all your money and break yourself for you to be struggling come the week after.
Yeah. And then you still gotta pay your taxes in January anyway.
Hello,
so
hello
you don't
somebody.
Do that.
They're coming.
They don't care.
Sounds like you're waiting in January to get a refund, okay?
Right.
Let's just, you know, everybody's in a different place,
well,
right?
Well, I'm in Kingston right now in the Amazon cart.
Got
a good $1,000 worth of toys. I told them we're going to have to cut this.
And won't play with most of them after 3 days, right?
Yeah.
So what I like to tell parents is don't put that stress on yourself to get those children everything on your list.
You're not getting everything.
And a lot of that is ego, too, for the parents. It's about, my children are an extension of me, so let me show you what I did, right?
Wow.
Really, it should be about asking your child, if you don't get anything else this holiday season, if you could only get one gift, what would that one gift be? See if you can hit that and let everything else fall to the wayside.
Right, a lot of people are creating experiences instead of gifts, like a trip or doing something like that. So
it'll
I've read a lot about that.
It'll last a lifetime.
I like that.
Last year we went to Disney World. That was actually more fun
than anything, right?
I say pay for experiences, not for things.
Yes, I agree with that, the memories.
But what can we do? What can we tell that person who is sad when the holidays come around?
You can tell them, I support you. tell me what you need in order to be okay. Let's not force them to get into activities because we want them there. You know, come on over to mama's house. Right. Everybody wants to see you. They may not be able to do that. So instead, you look for places and spaces to support them. Check in on them. Hey, are you okay? Mm-hmm. Do you need some quiet space? Do you need to go for a walk? Do you only want to come for an hour and then leave? Do you want a hotel room that's close to where we are but not necessarily in the house? So if you need a break, then you can step away. Right. It's really about having open an honest conversation to say, I see you struggling and I'm here to help, not judge you or get you to do what I want you
Spirit,
to do.
I have a very good question because a friend of mine is going through this now. They go back and forth to home, you know, or Chicago or whatever. And when they went back this time, they found out that like it's mentally abusive there. Like they're having a bad time with family, but
they're
because they're so conditioned to go back to home, they're finding out like,
this
this, I've outgrown this. What do you say to young people who feel like, well, maybe they're single and they have, that is their, you know, family. What do you say to people that maybe shouldn't go there because it's it's detrimental
don't
to their
do
mental
it.
Health.
And when you are triggered and you recognize that, that's when it's time to do your work to heal and realize you have two families. The one you're born into, can't do anything about it, and the one you create.
Message.
That get yourself together, create your family, and that, is and where you spend your time.
And would you expound to tell people not, literally they don't have to create
literally.
A family. I'm saying like a family of friends.
I think we get so inundated with the guilt that we're supposed to be so we have to do it. This
driven
is family.
Family. Driven,
no, ma'am. You are not required to set yourself on fire to keep other people warm. I don't care
what
their title is.
Baby, maybe do the
You are not obligated. Not to nobody. Not a mama, not a child, not a daddy, not a grandma. It don't matter.
Spirit, you know you deserve that show you got.
Girl, I was about to say the same thing.
It need to be an extension just on past couples challenges.
My gosh.
Come on, we're going to get it together. We did some good work. I can't wait for you to
see. Don't set yourself on fire to keep other people warm.
Well, if you or anyone, we thank you so much.
I love you guys.
If you or anyone you know has any questions or concerns regarding mental health, we encourage you to seek help. You're not alone. Spirit offers a free 10-minute consultation. So follow her at Talk2Spirit.
Thank you so much, Spirit. We appreciate you.
Yeah.